What's up guys, welcome to my show, Mad Stuff with Rob. I am Rob and I'm back with another DIY. Now this DIY is pretty cool because it showcases my personality as it is a combination of things I like. I like art because I'm an artist, so I make and create stuff. I also like to travel, so whenever I have free time, I step out and explore the world. And being a creative person, I want the space around me or the decor around me to have that creative, artistic touch. I'm not so much of a book person, but I enjoy reading graphic novels. So our next DIY, which is 3D letter bookends, it is a combination of all these things: art, room decor, travel, and books. And with this simple DIY, you can add a personal touch to your room. So get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. All right, let's start. So for the 3D letter bookend, I am going to add a little more personal touch by using my initials. So I have this big letter R printed here. So make sure the font is simple and bold like this. And also it'll be nice if the letter has more surface area at the bottom so that your bookends are more stable. Okay, now I'm going to cut it to transfer the same letter onto a cardboard. Also, when you're using a cutter, just be careful, don't hurt yourself. Okay, so our cutout is ready. Now I'm going to transfer the letter on the cardboard piece. This way I can get the same exact letter. To make our letter look 3D, I need two cardboard cutouts. So the tracing is done. And we have two letters here on the cardboard piece. You can see I have nice clean outlines. Now using a cutter or scissors, you can cleanly cut it. So there you go, our cardboard cutouts are ready. So this will become the front and back of the 3D letter. We also need the walls for the side. For that, I have cut some cardboard strips here. And using this, you can give the 3D letter the height and width it needs. So I'm taking one cardboard cutout and placing this cardboard strip next to it so that we know the exact length of the side that we need, and then just cut it cleanly. So you can see I have one of the sides right here. So I'm going to stick this with the glue gun. And you have to follow the same process for all the sides. Make sure you apply glue to all the corners, all the sides, and all the edges so that your structure is strong. Another great thing about working with cardboard is that because it's corrugated, it can bend very easily. So for all these round edges or corners, you can just stick it and then just bend it like this so that you get the curved shape. For all the curved edges, just apply the glue on the base, then put your strip on it and then just gently bend it so that it matches the curve of the letter, and then just hold it till the glue dries. And there you have it. We have added the sides or the walls to our 3D letter. Looks pretty 3D. But before we place the second cutout and block the whole shape like this, we are going to add some weight inside this cavity. To add weight, I am adding these small pebbles. Once you have laid all the pebbles, make sure they are lying flat. Now let's get the top layer in and stick it in place. All right, looks like we are done. But now we have the travel bit left. So to add the travel angle, I am going to use a map. That's right. Now you can see I have cut a map using the stencil. So the top part will be the letter R like this, which is a cutout from a map. But the bottom letter will be flipped. It fits perfectly on the other side. And for the sides or the walls, I have these strips. Now you can see that the strip is wider than the side of the 3D letter. The reason is that I want to cover the whole thing with the map, and this way I can easily do it. I'll place the strip like this, stick it in place, and then fold the sides. And this overlap will be covered by the cutout, giving a nice clean finish. To stick the map, I'm using white glue. And to remove the wrinkles or air bubbles, you can take a ruler or a credit card and just press it down gently. And with that, your 3D letter bookends are now ready. These bookends had my personality, my personal touch, things that I like. So if you are making a set of your own, don't forget to add your personality to it. And click pictures and share them with me so I get to know a little more about you guys. You know how to get in touch with me? I'm on Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram, and right here in this space making cool, fun, simple DIY videos just for you guys. I'll see you in my next video. Until then, do good and be good. Peace.